So today we are going to test SSDs of different types and find out how much of a performance difference there is between them. And we also have this really special Gen 4 NVMe SSD from Aorus, which is only supported on the AMD X570 and TRX 40 platforms at the moment, as we only have PCIe 4.0 support on the AMD side. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and let's find out if upgrading to this hot new tech is going to be worth it. So the SSDs that we'll be testing today are all from Gigabyte. We have a conventional SATA drive that we have had for many years. Then we have an M.2 NVMe drive which uses PCIe 3.0 interface, which is the most popular performance option these days. Then we have an add-in card SSD, which again uses PCIe 3.0, but instead of being in an M.2 form factor, we have to put it in one of the PCIe slots on the motherboard. And then we finally have the Aorus Gen 4 NVMe SSD with this hefty and really nice looking heatsink. You can of course remove these heatsinks and take out the SSDs to use your motherboard's heatsink, but the heatsink it has a pretty large surface area, and it also looks really nice, so we are not going to do that. This is the price difference between these SSDs. The 3rd gen NVMe SSD with fancy RGB heatsink costs almost as much as the 4th gen NVMe SSD, but if you go for the more basic Gigabyte NVMe SSD, you can find it for half the price for the same capacity and similar endurance. And then the AIC SSD costs the same as Gen 4 SSDs, and they have also launched a 4th gen PCIe AIC SSD, but we aren't cool enough to have it with us for this video. So let's find out how well these perform. Coming to boot times, we do see the Gen 4 SSD performing significantly better than other types of SSDs, and the AIC and M.2 Gen 3 SSDs perform identically as expected, and then the SATA SSD is also only a second behind the 3rd gen NVMEs. Then we ran Crystal Disk Mark, and it's here where you see the real difference these SSDs have in their transfer speeds, with the SATA SSD looking really bad in comparison, and the Gen 4 SSD showing the difference PCIe 4.0 has made. The Gen 4 SSD did heat up quickly, even with its big heatsink, as it consumes a lot of power, and it does throttle down a lot if it overheats. But if you are able to provide it decent enough airflow, you shouldn't face issues. Then we copied the Ultimate Cooler PC footage into our SSDs, and here we see a jaw-dropping difference between the time it takes to transfer a lot of data. This can be a really big time saver if you have to transfer large files quickly, and even though we were expecting the Gen 4 SSDs to be really fast, seeing the real-world difference being as big as the benchmarks is really great to see. We also imported these files into Adobe Premiere to see if there is a big difference, but there wasn't. Which is a trend that you are going to see more of, because not all applications can take advantage of the faster transfer speeds of these newer SSDs. So in game loading times, we don't see significant differences, with all the NVMe SSDs performing identically in Borderlands 3. Then in PUBG, there also isn't a mentionable difference, but the Gen 4 SSD is slightly faster. In Shadow of the Tomb Raider, we also see a very similar story with differences of a second or two. And then in Far Cry 5, we see the AIC SSD on top, but the difference is within the margin of error, so we are going to assume that all SSDs perform identically in this game. So those were the results of our tests, and as you could see, that the difference in performance varies a lot depending on what kind of workloads you will have. In the Windows boot times, we did see a significant improvement with the Gen 4 SSD, and if you are going to be transferring a lot of data, the Gen 4 SSDs will make a really big difference. But other than that, you really don't see enough of a difference that would make you grab the newest SSDs or choose the X570 platform over something older that still supports Ryzen 3rd gen processors. The move from hard drives with spinning disks to SSDs was a really giant leap in the way our computers accessed data. And while we do see a big difference between these SSDs in raw performance, most of the applications and games are not able to take advantage of higher transfer speeds, because there is a lot that goes on in addition to data transfer when it comes to how fast an application or a game loads. And that was going to be the conclusion for this video. But then I had a very enlightening conversation with Shatul from CompCraft, who told me about their god-level video editing build aimed to handle 8K 16-bit DPX and EXR real-time playback in DaVinci Resolve. They convert the 8K RedRAW footage to 8K 16-bit DPX or EXR files, which means that each frame in this format actually takes up around 205 MB. So they require a 5 GB per second of random read bandwidth, which means that anything slower than multiple Gen 4 NVMe SSDs will not work for their use case. This system has 8 2 TB of Aorus Gen 4 SSDs in RAID 0, and they can just about manage the performance needed for real-time playback of their footage. So if you are an enthusiast or a professional who has the use case for the extremely fast data transfer rate of these Gen 4 SSDs, then they will be a godsend, as it will allow you to do things that just weren't possible before, like playing 8K 16-bit footage in an NLE. But for an average user whose focus is to just play games or do everyday tasks, there isn't big enough of a difference to justify the difference in price or the lower capacities that you may have to settle for on your budget. But then, the Aorus Gen 4 SSDs aren't that expensive when you consider the kind of speeds it offers for some workloads, and if you are building a high-end PC like we did in a recent video, the additional cost of these SSDs isn't going to be that much. So I can recommend this as a purchase that makes sense if you understand the kind of difference it makes in different workloads. So let me know which one of these SSDs you would go for in the comment section below, and I'll also have links to buy these SSDs in the video description. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it to be helpful. Subscribe to the channel with bell icon so you don't miss out on future videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.